Respected students, today we will study about an introduction to control system. Okay. So here you can see on the screen I have shared a control system figures different for your acquaintance. So you can just see control system, what are the types. Okay. So moving on, the contents will be concept of automatic controls, open loop and closed loop, concept of feedback, requirements, ideal control system. Now, why automatic control systems are required? What is the need? Why we cannot rely on the complete mechanical systems, or why we cannot rely on complete system which is manual? Okay, so automatic control has a vital role in the advance of engineering and science. Okay, it is more important in space vehicle systems, missile guidance, robotic systems, and day-to-day modern manufacturing and industrial process. And now the example which we are having is numerical control of machine tools in manufacturing and industry. As you can see, in industry, number of processes are automated. Okay, different automobile industries which are making automobile cars or which are making machines, they put their whole assembly of the manufacturing line in auto mode. Only a person is deputed to see if the process or the routine is being hampered, or if there is any problem, it will just notice that. Rest all the processes are automated. Second is design of autopilot system in aerospace industries, design of cars and trucks in automobile industries, and speed governors. Now next is, it is also essential in industrial operation, as if you have to control the pressure in the boiler, if you want to control the temperature, if you want to control the humidity, viscosity of the fluid and flow in the process of the industry. So these are the continuous system which requires continuous monitoring, continuous reception of the data. Okay. Now automatic control helps in attaining optimal performance of the dynamic system. Okay. Now dynamic system and static system, these are the two systems. Static systems are related with the static things. Now dynamic means continuously moving object, which you have to do in real time. Now improving productivity, relieving the drudgery of many routine repetitive manual operations. Now let us see an examples of automatic system. You can see automatic water level controller. As the float will rise, automatically the supply valve will go down, and it will cut off the water supply. Okay, and the load valve part operation, when the load valve part is open, automatically the water level will go down. As the water level will go down, your float will also go down. As the float will go down, it will pull up the supply valve. And the second is automatic engine speed controller. You can see the throttle valve. Okay, this is flyball controller. So it is depends upon throttle valve, bell, crank, lever. So this will control the speed. Okay, so this is the example of your automatic control system. Here there is no manual thing, no person is being what you can say, deputed the duty for to open the load valve, to close the supply valve, or no person here will are here to, what you can say, pull up the float. Okay, so this is complete automatic system with feedback. The automatic water level controller is with feedback system. So the concept of automatic control, an automatic control system is a preset closed loop control system that requires no operator human action. Closed loop means a system with a feedback. Okay. For example, the best system in feedback is automatic level. Feedback means if the water level goes down, so the feedback will be taken by float and it will open the valve. Okay. Now here, automatic control uses application of mechanism to the operation and regulation of process without continuous and direct intervention. Now the process remains in normal range for control system. Okay. An automatic control system has two process variables. Number one is controlled variable and a manipulated variable. Okay. The controlled variable is a process variable that is maintained at a specific value or within a specific range. Okay. In the previous example, a storage tank level is controlled with a is a controlled variable. Okay, there is no manipulation in that variable. Now in manipulated variable, this is acted by the control system to maintain the control variable. Means we have to apply that variable to control the system. Okay. The flow rate of the water supply to the tank is manipulated variable. Okay, you can understand the difference between these two. Now functions of automatic control. There are four basic functions in automatic control. One is measurement, comparison, computation, and correction. So these are the four basic parameters in which are used in automatic control to measure and then to compare. After comparison to compute and that computation and this correction. Now, what is the basic definition of a system? How will you define a system? It is a combination of arrangement of different physical components which act together, okay, as an entire unit to achieve a certain objective. The best example for this is your water level tank. Okay, all your float valve, water inlet valve, water outlet valve tank, okay, these are all physical components. They are arranged in such a manner which are used to attain a certain objective. Now in this, the objective is to provide a water without the water getting overflow. Okay. Now example, a classroom is a physical system, a room along with the combination of bench, blackboard, fans, lightning arrangement, okay, which act as an elementary system. Now in classroom, professor is delivering a lecture in his lecture. It becomes a control system as it tries to regulate, direct, or command the students in order to achieve objective. Okay, so these are basic example. Now basic definitions. Here you can see plant figure shows the process. In process, there are two inputs, manipulated input and disturbance input, and finally you get a response variable. The portion of a system which is to be controlled or regulated is called a plant. A plant may be a piece of equipment or just a set of machine part. Okay. Plant depends upon the necessity. The purpose of plant is to perform a particular operation. Okay. Example, mechanical device, heating furnace, a chemical reactor, or even a spacecraft. Okay. Now any operation can be controlled, any operation to be controlled is called a process. Okay. Now which you want to control, that is called as a process. Examples are chemical, economic, and biological process. You can see best example is economic process, chemical process, and biological process. Basic definition, controller, the element of the system itself or external to the system which controls the plant or process is called controller. Okay, the on off switch to control bulb. Here you can see the flow control, pump controller. Okay, now in this comparator will compare, a controller will control, and manipulating variable will be given to the process. The disturbance will be there after this unmeasured output and measured output we will get. So this is a basic definition of controller. Control is the main element which will control the process. Now basic definition is input. What is the input? Input is nothing but an excitation applied for the input to control a system for an external energy. What is output? You will receive some response. Okay, it is a particular signal of interest or an actual response obtained from a control system when the input is applied. Without input, you are not going to get any output. So for analyzing this, this is a disturbance input, command input. Command input, controller, manipulated variable, disturbance input, process, controlled output. Okay. Now basic definition of disturbance. What is a disturbance? Disturbance is a signal which tends to adversely affect the value of the output of a system. Okay, you need to count this. Okay. Disturbance are undesirable and unavoidable effects beyond our control. Okay. Generated from the outside process environment and from within. Okay. If such disturbance is generated within the system itself, it is called as an internal disturbance. The disturbance generated outside the system acting as an extra input to the system in addition to its normal input affecting the output adversely is called as an external disturbance. So in short, the external input which you do not want will affect your process, will affect your output, is called as a disturbance. For example, the best disturbance is when the two persons are having a call with each other, and if there is a problem in a network, okay, and the voice is getting cut. So this is an external disturbance. The two persons are talking with each other, will have nothing to do with that. Okay, so this is a best example of the disturbance. Now, the classification of control system. As we have seen the introduction to control system, what is a system, what is a control. Now we'll move, there are certain types in which this control system is classified. Number one is a natural control system, one is universe, and second is a human body. Number two is a man-made control system, which are vehicles, aeroplanes. Number three, manual control system, room temperature regulation via electric fan. Second is a water level controller. Number four is automatic control system, room temperature regulation via AC, and human body temperature control. Now, classification of control system number fifth is open loop control system, washing machine, toaster, and electric fan. Okay. Second is a closed loop control system, refrigerator, autopilot system, and driverless car. Number seventh is a linear versus non-linear control system. A control system in which output varies linearly with the input is called as a linear control system. You can see in the graph. Number eight is time variant versus time invariant. Okay. In which time variant means it is depend upon, it varies upon the time. And time invariant means system is not dependent upon the time. Number nine is continuous data versus discrete data. Means continuous data, the control system, all system variable are the function of a time in continuous. In discrete, all the data variables are function of a time intervals. Okay. Deterministic versus stochastic control system. A control system is a deterministic if the response to the input is predictable and repeatable. Deterministic means you can assume that, okay, the system will give certain outputs which you know. And stochastic means if not, the control system is stochastic. Now finally, there is a graph classification of control system. Control system: natural, man-made, manual, and automatic. In automatic we are having open loop and closed loop. In open loop we are having non-linear, linear, and closed loop also non-linear, linear. In non-linear we are having time variant, time invariant, and in linear we are having time variant and time invariant. So that's all. Rest open loop and closed loop system we will study in next lecture. I hope you understand all. So the conclusion summary is, we have studied the introduction of the system, control system, what are its classification, and all of the above. Okay, so thank you.